as much to them to check them out. She's actually called me before telling me that she's fallen and she needs help getting up, and I wasn't able to immediately get to her. My brother and I live with the guilt every single day, knowing that the house is completely inhabitable and the house is killing my mom. Something unusual, I gravitate to. There's lots of fascinating stuff out there. I just have to have nothing more.
I'm Joaquin, and Dolores is my mother. Our house is a freaking disaster.
I realize it's not a living house because there's too much stuff in it.
My God, you name it, it's in it. You need a pair of speakers? She's got 8. You need a computer screen? She's got 10 of them. You need a screwdriver? You can't find it. But she's got 20. Granted, she has a lot of unique and interesting things, but we have like 27 frying pans. How many eggs do you have?
A lot of stuff I pick up open to sell. Lots of times the stuff I find on the city streets. I find it at thrift shops. There aren't sales. Every once in a while, I find something valuable enough to pay dirt.
I'm Anna, and Dolores is my mom. Finding that piece of treasure that she now made $200 on, it makes her feel justified for collecting more and more stuff. When I was little, my mom would do yard sales. She would also do flea markets.
She dragged me out of bed on Saturday morning, and I'd have to bring 6, 7, 10 suitcases full of things down 5 flights of stairs so she could sell at a flea market all day.
Being honest, I was not very good at figuring out how to get ahead economically. Just slowly and gradually.
This collecting thing started getting out of control for my mom after we graduated college.
I guess she did, you know, what she wanted to do to occupy herself. She used to go walking and, you know, collect stuff.
There was no real way to do anything about it with my brother and I both being busy with work and kids.
She drove tons of things out here piecemeal, you know, one by one. It's taken her years to collect all that and bring it out here. And now it's at the point where, well, when you look at our house, it's like, this is insane.
Joaquin hates my stuff, hates the hoarder. He takes it personal.
The way she is living these days brings stress to me and my whole family.
The whole situation is very frustrating for all of us and our spouses. I'm Gretchen, and Dolores is my mother-in-law.
There is a big strain on the relationship between me and Joaquin because he does spend a lot of time trying to deal with Dolores and her things, but she doesn't understand why people are so frustrated. To her, this is her life. Leave me alone.
We'd like our grandkids to spend time with her. It's not like we can bring them down to visit.
It's a fire truck. You go in there and you're not coming out. I guess the fire alarm malfunctioned and went off, and the neighbors rightly so called the fire department.
The fire department was not happy with what they saw. Someone told me they sent in the smallest fireman they had, and it still took them half an hour to get down to the front door.
I got a notice in the mail. They said I had to empty out the place.
If she keeps going the way she's going now, there's going to be a lot of hard work coming down the line. There's other buildings around that building. God forbid it goes up, you'll go up like a tinderbox.
BRB.
I would like to see the house to be where it's what I would call clean.
I do want to go back to being a mom. And it's been a long time. Physical pain, but a lot of her pain is actually more emotional than it is physical. So she's created this crisis from an unconscious level. So when there's been full of children and long for the age and things like that, and, that's not happening. Quite honestly, I haven't done this very often. Just kind of blocked out of my mind, tried to ignore. This is how she's been coping with her kids being gone. Just not going to the places and spaces that they share together. It's too painful. Is it possible that you let it stay full of trash so you don't have to feel so empty? People like Diana, who have been abused in Diana's case in childhood as well as in her marriage, oftentimes do have maladaptive coping behaviors. This is their self-destruct. And it's keeping what you say you want away. For children, leaving just brought up another level of trauma, of stress, and the hoarding is a direct correlation to her grieving.
I need to thank mom, my family. But what's my body can use it, then?
There's a lot of pain in there.
There's a lot of money. Fear from being married and very abusive. Just like you were very abusive towards all of us. And it's just been something I'm never tired of.
It's time to let this It's time to send them on the way. But to where we ask. The struggle with the clean one is that it's not just about the war, but about everything that has happened in her life.
But if I start crying, I need to talk. So I have to hope that he
can heal what you can't heal. It really is the path to your healing. Letting her just feel healing.